So you said, can you please bring a sentence where ahad means one, and then
according
one of.
I think the Muslim scholars are confirming that. Yeah, it's give me Islamic sources where the word ahad is used as one of and also one.
Come, let's talk.
Yes,
no,
Qadi.
Yes, Qadi. You don't like Yasir Qadi? You don't like Yasir Qadi?
Yes, Qadi is a kafir.
Yes, Qadi is a kafir. Listen, did you listen that? Yasir Qadi is kafir. I know Allah doesn't make sense. I know Allah is stupid.
The one
if any scholar
God
says that ahad is one of, he's not a scholar. Talking about sex in Islam.
He's not talking about sex in Islam.
He's talking about sex. He's like, don't be Shia, don't be Sunni, go to Jesus. I asked him, how many sects are there?
There is one Christ which everyone needs to bow down.
And there is one Allah as well. But that's a dumb analogy to say because there are different sects.
Are you Orthodox? Are you Protestant? Are you Catholic?
Are you sure?
Yes.
Are you born again?
No, there are three daughters.
Are you very positive about
there
it?
There is one Allah and three daughters.
Smiling when you lie.
Stop.
There is one Allah and three daughters.
Where?
Yeah, it's in the Quran.
In the Quran.
Surah 53.
The Quran
Surah 53. Surah 53.
What does that mean?
One of.
You can't even speak Arabic. Ahad means the one.
Ahad means one of.
One of
Quran clearly
since when says, you know.
Yeah. Since your scholars are telling us and that's Arabic.
Which scholar says that it's one of?
You want to hear?
I know nothing.
Is it one of?
It's even, one of.
Even
so the verse says, say Allah is
even
one of.
One who wrote
yeah. What does that? That doesn't even make sense.
I know. Allah doesn't make sense. I know. Allah doesn't make sense. Surah 112 doesn't make sense.
What would make more sense?
It's not
Allah is one. Say Allah is one of.
Yes, he's a
both of them are coming from Islam. Islamic Allah doesn't make sense. Let me show you who are banning that. I'm gonna show you.
Even Quran says Allah has three daughters.
Wait. Why are you going to the translation? I'm gonna let Muslim scholars tell.
Okay. One of she's gonna bring us some Shi'i, probably some messed up Shi'i, and
okay,
he's a scholar.
No, just bring a scholar and we'll see.
2946.
I'm a real scholar, yeah.
So it would make more sense to say Allah is the one rather than Allah is one of.
I know it will make sense, but I am sorry. Allah doesn't make sense.
What does Ahmed mean?
No one knows.
I know Arabic. I can speak Arabic. How do you know, man?
95% Muslims, they don't know the Arabic. That's why they don't know their religion.
What is this? That's a YouTube video.
Sufi. No, it's a Sufi.
Safina. What is this?
Wait.
Which scholar is this?
Wait. I'm going to give you all the scholars you need.
She just
walked around. Patience.
Okay,
I'm going to give you all
and 11 second video.
Is she your girlfriend?
No, she's not my girlfriend.
Can you bring the scholar?
I'm going to give you a scholar.
Thank you.
Wait.
Give us a proper scholar. Don't give us some Sufis on that.
I'm going to give you a scholar. Wait.
Just wait, man. Just wait.
I know Allah doesn't make sense. I know Allah is stupid.
Any scholar says that ahad is one of, he's not a scholar.
Baby, I can get you from internet that Jesus was Superman. Or Mickey Mouse.
Okay,
very easy.
I have to offer you something else for your offer, but all I can say is go and get Mohammed's mother. I'm getting a scholar. Wait.
She wears the same cartoon that went and cursed Jesus. That same cartoon cursed Jesus. You know that or not? Hey, Hatun. Can you please speak to me?
Who's Jesus' father?
Okay. Who's the scholar?
Wait, coming.
What's the name of the scholar?
Wait, coming.
Give us names.
Wait, coming. Patience is a virtue according to Islam.
Remember that Exodus?
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Muhammad Rahman Rahim.
And then it's like, it means only Allah's God.
Okay, which scholar is it?
It's a video. Wait, come.
I'm not going to be patient for 50 minutes.
It's
wait.
Not going to be 15 minutes. You don't even have time for Allah's nonsense. I can't do much about it.
Ahad means the one.
Ahead, please.
Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus.
Can you check the time for the camera?
Come to Jesus.
You know Arabic more than me.
Come to Jesus.
Which color? Which color is it?
Come, let's talk.
Yes, of course. You don't like Yasser Kadir? You don't like Yasser Kadir?
Yasser
Kadir is a kafir. Listen, did you listen that? Yasser Kadir is kafir.
He might be kafir. Why is he kafir?
He might be kafir.
Why is he kafir?
He might be kafir.
Listen.
He might be kafir. He might be kafir.
He
might be kafir. But you know, he still qualifies to talk about Islam from Medina unit.
Wait, he can do kufr without being kafir. He says that the Quran is imperfect. First of all.
I know, I'm getting my back.
The Quran is imperfect.
He is right. He's right.
So he's closer to you than me. He's closer to you than me.
He's right.
Be quiet.
Okay,
the Ringwire says that he said Ahed is one of.
Yo, you need to tell a scholar, a proper scholar.
Okay, she said Yasser Qadi. Can you bring now the proof where it says that he says Ahed means one of?
Rightly saying, Quran is not a perfect book.
What is it?
Check.
واحد. What the hell?
Al-Wahid. Ahed and Al-Wahid is the same thing.
No.
It is the same people. You identified as the kafir. It is the same people. Actually, it is coming from the same God. Where it has been expressed, Allah says the dumbest things. Allah says the dumbest.
What does Ahad mean?
One. According to who?
One.
According to your scholar, it is one of.
Ahad and Al-Wahid is the same thing.
Ahad and Al-Wahid is the same thing.
Thank you.
He don't know.
We compare this. It's in Arabic. It's not in Arabic.
I don't care what Yasser Qadi does. I care what he says. And that someone who studied from the Medina University, someone who is teaching Dawah is a kafir now, go and deal with it. Of course, I want to take the opportunity.
Russia and America.
I want to take the opportunity. He says China. Don't lie about it.
No. He said Russia and America. Be quiet in this conversation.
I want to bring this to everyone's attention. Since Yasser Qadi is identified as a kafir by Muslims, he needs to watch out. From now on, his life is in danger. Yasser Qadi, watch out. Your Muslim brothers are not going to be nice.
She can never give us a reputable scholar.
So, now, scholars after scholars, and the dictionary after dictionary, they identify Ahad means one of. Now, I shoved him. I don't care you disregard him. I don't care you butchered him, sliced him, and then put it in the bin. I don't care whatever you've done to him. But right now, I am very much concerned what is going to happen to him. When you publicly identified him as a kafir, I want to reach to wherever he lives. All the FBI people, protect Yasser Qadi from the Muslim people. Protect him from the Muslim people. Muslim people. Now, since Ahad has been explained as one of, Allah is one of something, let's ask the question. One of what? Answer my question.
Answer my question.
Answer my question.
Can we read it in
full? Answer my question.
Okay. Thank you. Let's read it in full. Okay, please. Thank you. قل هو الله أحد. الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا احد.
Okay.
Put in your mouth.
Let's say hypothetically.
Hatun.
Bro.
Allah is one of
what? They can't hear you. It's fine. It's fine.
Just bro. Bro. That's what I'm asking.
The mic is here. The mic is here. It's fine.
Okay.
They can't hear you.
قل هو الله احد. Let's say hypothetically. It says one of. Let's bring the next verse. Allah الصمد. Allah the eternal. Absolute. How would it make sense for the end of the verse to say one of and then the next verse bring Allah's name again? Does that mean that the two verses come together?
And secondly, her scholars. Yes, sir. That's it.
It would make way more sense to say that قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ is He is Allah, the one and only, for the next verse to bring Allah's name again.
So I think
Allah, the eternal, the absolute.
Ibrahim, so it is good that you think it doesn't make sense and it will make better sense. Because if it says Allah is one and then Allah is absolute and all
because
that
junk, let me finish. How can it stop at one
off? Let me finish.
No, this is my argument.
It is not. Okay, yeah, I am responding. I am responding.
She had my question.
So, you are like 18 to 19? You are
15.
15. You are 15 years old and I am grateful. We already recognize that Allah doesn't make that much sense. Whatever Allah says, Ahad is the word. Allah is the Ahad is the word. What Muhammad passed it to people. I showed the scholars and the dictionaries. It states that Ahad is one of. So therefore, I am sorry that Allah doesn't make sense. I am asking the basic question. Also, I am stressed with the presence of those people among my brothers. They already spotted him. That's not the point. So I want to know. You know them. Do something about it.
I know when they come or something.
Do something about it. You know people and you don't do anything about it.
What do you want me to do? Look how big they are.
So what? You said you will stop it. You said
when they come.
What is it? Like they are already walking on him. They already shuffled him. They already shuffled him around. They already shuffled him around. Anyway, so while Allah is one of what? That's my question. My second question is, I am disappointed.
Let's go, guys.
I am disappointed.
Okay, no problem.
I am sorry that you don't look nice on the camera. I am disappointed that Allah is non saying things which is nonsense.
Okay, can I respond to your argument?
Yeah.
Okay.
So
she brought Yasser Qadi and Nu'man Ali Khan saying that one ahad, which is an adjective. You didn't show me the dictionary. Can you show it again? Okay, no problem. Okay. So ahad, first of all, is an adjective. How can an adjective describe one of? That's my response. How can ahad, which is an adjective, mean one of? Okay, no problem. That's my answer. Yeah.
So that is third time I'm asking you the same question.
Okay.
According to your scholars, they are Muslim scholars. They express Ahad means one of. You already heard it from the video. Would you like to hear it again?
You just bought.
Would you like to hear it again?
Can you please show the camera the explanation on why he said Ahad is one of?
Okay, in that case, be calm and listen.
Okay.
Be calm and listen then. Okay. Listen what he's going to say.
Let's watch the video together. You can bring both of them if you want. I want you.
No.
Not only for him that he quoted Ahad is one of, I want you to show the explanation. If he has a good explanation, that means there's no point in bringing him.
No worries. Wait.
I have one point before she speaks. Is Nu'man Ali Khan and Yasser Qadi Arabic speaking scholars?
Firstly, by the way, they are American. American scholars. American. They were born in America, blah, blah, blah. We do not accept them, firstly, right? So therefore, If you're here trying to bring someone, bring us reputable scholars that we accept. No, Yasser Qadi and Omar Ali Khan born in Mecca.
Who do you
all right, bring us somebody from Saudi Arabia, you know, to, you know, a reputable
Christian
scholar, not American.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Christian Prince. Do you accept Christian Prince as a scholar and an Arab speaker?
No.
Why would I accept a priest?
Share the video.
For what?
You don't know Christian
Prince. Can we please watch it first together? Yeah. Us two, and then we
Christian
can.
Prince.
Thank you.
Oh, Christian Prince.
Christian.
Why would I accept?
No. Don't stop in the middle. No. Show the whole of the video.
He speaks Arabic.
He's lying. He says he's an ex-Muslim. He's not.
He speaks Arabic.
He never said he's
ex-Muslim.
What?
He never said he's ex-Muslim.
He never said ex-Muslim. Don't lie.
I thought he did. So what? If he speaks Arabic. A 10-year-old can come.
Can we please watch the video?
Right. I'm waiting your brother to
show it. Ahmed, be quiet. Yeah. She wants to show the video.
Okay. So, now,
to the beginning, I want to watch the whole video.
Shush now.
Why are you telling me to shush?
Shush now, I'm gonna respond what you said, okay?
I'm a patient man, I want to watch the whole video.
Okay, you are patient now. Okay,
I'm a patient man, I want to watch the whole video.
Okay.
Go in the middle.
Shush now.
I want to watch the whole video. Thank you.
Lord, please help me to be patient as much as this gentleman is.
Okay,
so now, let me first make my case. I am very much disappointed that you are cherry-picking your scholars.
You're cherry-picking scholars.
Sir, why are you cutting me off?
I'm not cutting you off.
You just cut me off. That was cutting off. You said you are patient.
And I responded.
I didn't ask you a question.
Lie,
I am just...
Be quiet.
Now you're crying around, man. Okay, speak. You can speak now.
Don't speak.
I'm patient. I can wait.
Okay. So, thank you. So, I am very disappointed that you've been very much, I think it is called racist, towards Muslims who live in America, because they choose to live in America, and they are Muslims who went to Saudi Arabia. Why are you cutting me off? What happened to your patience skills? What happened to your patience?
My patient skills can be used in watching the whole video.
Allah is going to destroy him. Shush now.
You don't want to show me the video. Cut to the chase. Show me the video.
After I identify.
You speaking, paraphrasing the video. I want to watch it myself.
I'm going
to
show you the video.
I wanted to show you the video
10 minutes ago. You didn't want to listen. So now let me identify something. It's up to you. Whatever you want to do, it's up to you. So after you identified Muslims who live in America, and then you've been racist towards them, I do acknowledge that is very much Islamic, and that's absolutely fine. Followers of Islam is racist towards their brothers, and I showed the two scholars, you cherry picked them, and then you identified them as kafir. I want to express. So, look, their scholars are committing zina, and then this Muslim gentleman is saying, don't expose their sin publicly.
Don't publicize.
Don't publicize. Yeah. He had sex outside of marriage.
I said a sin.
Like Muhammad did. Okay. So now. Since those scholars are being destroyed, this video is 8 minutes 18 seconds.
I have no problem
watching
it.
Okay. Listen.
I can't even hear it.
Shush, if you shush, you listen.
I can't hear it.
If you shush, you will listen.
Can we watch it asu?
If you shush, you will hear.
In chapter 112, verse 1 in the Quran, it says that Allah is Ahad. What is the correct translation of this verse? How do we properly understand it? Most English translations will render this as Allah is one. In this video, I'm going to show a number of clips. One of them is from our brother Christian Prince. Another is from a brother who only has content in Arabic, but I will be providing translation for what he says. Another is from a Muslim scholar, Noman Ali Khan. To give sort of the foundation of this video, to get us started, I'm sure many of you have heard this from Christian Prince before. What does Ahad mean? He often gets Muslims calling him up, or he's responding to Muslims, and he tells them what the true meaning of Ahad is in Arabic.
Where in the Quran it says Allah is one?
The
word Ahad does not mean one, my friend. Who taught you Arabic? Did you know Arabic? وَمَا يُعَلِّمَانِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ What the word ahad here mean? Exactly the same word. It does not mean one, my friend. It does not mean one. Let us see a translation. Your Muslim translation, chapter 2, verse 102. It says one of.
As you can see, Christian Prince lets us know that ahad does not mean one, but instead means one of. Here's another clip from our brother who speaks in Arabic, and there'll be a translation in the text to follow along.
قل هو الله أحد أحد هذه يعني جزء من الكل واحد من واحد من وليس واحد بدليل أن القرآن استخدم قال يا فإلهنا وإلهكم واحد هنا استخدم كلمة واحد الذي لا ثانية له في اللغة وفي المصطلح وفي العرف معناه لا ثانية له هو الوحيد هنا صحيح أما أحد من ناحية اللغة واللسان العربي يعني جزء من الكل.
Once again, like Christian Prince said, this brother says that the word أحد does not mean واحد. It doesn't mean one, but instead it means one of. أحد refers to a part within the whole, a part within the whole. This means that when the verse says Allah is Ahad, it's saying that He's one of something in a larger category or group of things. What is Allah one of? Now we have a clip from a Muslim scholar, Noman Ali Khan, who provides us with an amazing admission that not only does the word Ahad mean one of in the genitive construct, and when it's used negatively, it means no one or not anyone. Here's a clip. He begins by translating the verse for us.
He is Ahad. There were two sentences fused into one. When you have two khabar, that's what happens linguistically. Two sentences are fused into one. And the way we would translate them is, He is Allah, comma, one. And I actually, one is really not a good translation of Ahad. The first thing we need to know is the difference between Wahid and Ahad. Wahid and Ahad. The word Ahad is, the word Wahid, you know, Wahid, Ithnain, Thalath, this is what? One. Wahid means one. So how come Allah doesn't say, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ وَاحِد? Ahad is used negatively, negatively only. It's not used in a positive sense. It's only used not anyone at all. وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. Let no one at all commit shirk with Allah. Not no one at all. So that ahad is an absolute negation. That's where ahad is used. It's not used in a positive. When you want to speak in the positive, you use wahid. When you want to speak in the negative, you use ahad. Especially the exclusive, the absolute kind of negative. That's the first thing. But the thing is, in this surah, ahad is not being used in the negative, it's being used in the positive. So it's already unique. It's not something that normally happens in Arabic. The only other, so it's ahad is used in the negative. The second place ahad is used is in idafa. أحدكم أيود أحدكم right would any of you like أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه in Surah Al-Hujurat would any of you like would any one of you like that they would eat the dead flesh of their dead brother etc right that أحدكم when it's one of now I'm saying إضافة that's the technical term the English term is one of so one of them one of you one of the Muslims أحد المسلمين أحدكم أحدهما By itself, it's only used in the negative. If you want to use it in the positive, you have to add something else to it. It becomes part of something else. One of, or the first of, etc., etc.
Not only do we get a definition from Numan here.
Not anyone at all. One of.
He also states that أحد should not be properly translated as one.
And I actually, one is really not a good translation of Ahad.
Confirming exactly what was said earlier by our brother Christian Prince and our other brother. Now he makes another admission that the word Ahad, as it is used in chapter 112 verse 1, is the only exception to the rule. It's the only time that the word is used in this way. Of course I disagree with him, but what he's admitting to here is that if the word Ahad here is used positively and not in a genitive construct, then it would be the only time it is ever used like that in the entire Quran. What he's about to say here is that the word Ahad, every single time it's used in the Quran, it is only ever used to mean one of, or if it's used in a negation, not anyone. Of course, as a Muslim scholar, he tries to argue for the fact that it doesn't mean one of many when it's used with Allah, but him admitting that every other time it's used in the Quran is used in that way or in the negation, it always means one of many or one of many others within a larger category.
The only place in Arabic literature where this word is used in the positive without any further attribution is Surah Al-Ikhlas. That's it. There's nowhere else. Some oversimplify it and say Ahad is not used for anyone other than Allah. That's not clear enough. Ahad is used for other than Allah. But the word Ahad in the positive, without any idafa in it, in that way linguistically, is never ever used for anyone other than Allah.
So your school is expressing Ahad means one of?
Okay.
He already listened.
So Nu'man Ali Khan, in that context, talked about Al-Wahid and Ahad. In that point, he got it wrong. Can I please explain why? Okay. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ is grammatically wrong. Saying that, it makes no sense. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ means the same meaning as saying Allah is the one. Why? Because أَحَدْ is an adjective describing Allah's tawheed.
Let me respond.
Okay, no problem.
Let me respond. So, I am very much disappointed that
no problem,
as someone who is only under 20, discredits a scholar who studied Arabic
no problem.
And knows Arabic very well and identified
this
the word Ahad.
He doesn't get
listen,
for
listen,
it.
Listen, listen, sir, why are you cutting me off? Why are you cutting me off?
Why are you cutting me off? I'm sorry.
So, while your scholar expressed the word Ahad as one of and he identified Ahad.
She knows it by heart.
He identified word as Ahad as one of.
And she's
I never said.
He says one of them.
Why are you cutting me?
Okay, why I'm sorry, he spoke.
So if
he spoke, if you are, can you tell him to be
so
quiet?
Just a moment.
Can you tell him to be
so
quiet?
So if you are
can
sorry, you when you say sorry, you don't put your smiling face on. When you say sorry, you don't repeat the same thing again and again and then use that word sorry again. I'm sorry, I'm going
to
punch you again. It doesn't work like that.
Know,
so now,
you get very, very angry
now,
easily.
Surah 112. Ahad means one of according to your scholars. And even there is a hadith expresses okay. That Ahad is one of, which is, word has been used there. I shoved you the dictionary, and then one and one of is different in Arabic. Why are you cutting me off again?
I'm sorry. No.
If you are sorry, don't repeat the things again. So, you were patient enough to listen to the... You were patient enough to listen to the scholar. No, because a scholar committed zina, therefore you are discrediting the scholar. I can't do much about it. Word Ahad is also been used in a hadith, and it is one of. Therefore, my question still stands. What is Allah one of? Is Allah one of what? That's very basic question. That's very basic
right.
Question.
Right, your time now, bro. Go on.
Okay.
The floor is yours.
Okay.
Go on.
Hala. Okay. Sorry. Can you please read this? Because, okay.
Right. Ahad is a Middle Eastern proverb primarily used
okay.
By Muslims and
source?
Jews in Arabic. Ahad means one.
No, no. What is your source?
Okay, what should we bring? Whatever you want.
No, he's saying the dictionary. He's saying the dictionary. He's saying the dictionary.
Do you not use Google as well? Do you not use Google as well?
She's acting like she's...
I simply went to your scholar. The one you butchered. The one you told everyone that he committed zina. And also I used Yasir Qadir. And then I can give you more scholars. And then I can give you a hadith. It is one.
We've already said we want reputable scholars. We want reputable scholars, not scholars that are dead like this. Right?
Mono.
You want the mic? Cause she's
the mic's yours.
Is it what?
Yeah,
is it ours?
Okay.
What are you doing?
Okay. So, to explain the word ahad, can we can also use the next verse. Allahu Samad.
I want you to first explain the ahad and then we move to the next verse.
Okay.
Step by step.
Ahad. Okay. Ahad. Ahad in Arabic
but that's the thing, because you don't even understand Arabic. You don't know that words in Arabic could have different meanings in different contexts. So using one context of one word cannot be attributed to another word in its different context. So ahad in one context can be different as ahad in another context. In that context, in قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَد is not the same as the other surah, as the other verse that you brought. Why? Because you can bring the context. Okay, so ahad can be used in different contexts to describe differently. Like, are you trying to understand what I'm saying?
I'm just trying to understand.
Okay, so ahad, maybe it can be used as one-off in other contexts. But here, if we take the context of Surah Al-Ikhlas, you bought the other...
Give me an example from the Quran, okay?
Can we agree that you bought another verse that says that Ahad is one-off?
So,
you bought another verse.
Just a moment.
I forgot the verse name, but...
I said there is a hadith. So now you said Ahad, change from one context to other context.
Yeah, because this is the Arabic.
Give me a context where Ahad is being used and confirmed by scholars as one.
As one?
Do you want to be intentional in the camera? In that case, just come to my side.
Okay, yeah. Okay, so can you please repeat the question? So you said, can you please bring a sentence where Ahad means one and then one off?
According to Muslim scholars are confirming that. Yeah, give me Islamic sources where the word Ahad is used as one off and also one. And then also, can you be kind enough and then tell us in what it means in Arabic?
Okay, can you bring different definitions of Ahad, please?
So what is your source you are going to go?
The Arabic language.
You are going to dictionary? Is that correct?
Okay, let's go dictionary.
I'm asking what is your plan?
Okay, my plan is to use two different sentences to describe two different situations where Ahad can be described as one or one off. We can both agree that al-wahid is a noun. So using al-wahid with a noun before wouldn't make sense, because using two nouns together wouldn't make sense.
Allah in the verse is the noun. The verse, does Allah say wahid or Allah ahad?
Allah, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَد.
So Allah doesn't use wahid.
No, Allah doesn't use wahid. Al-wahid.
Allah doesn't use that one. So Allah uses ahad. Now, show me the references where ahad is used as one of as well as one.
Okay.
You mean in the Quran or what?
No, different definitions of ahad.
Different definitions of ahad. No problem.
Okay, write dictionary. Sorry for wasting time.
Sorry, Alhamdulillah.
Okay.
So wahid is one, ahad is one of. So we are trying to figure out the word ahad is used as one and one of in the different parts of the Islamic teachings.
Okay. So this is a dictionary of
an Arabic dictionary of ahad.
Give me a Quranic verse, for example. Ahad is used as one of.
Oh, she wants a verse from the Quran actually.
Oh, from Islam.
Because
we heard a Muslim scholar who expressed ahad means is
one of. Scholar, please.
He's a scholar. I'm not sorry actually. He committed zina. He should repent. I am sorry that you are hiding this sin under the carpet.
It's not hiding. It's a sin if you expose another person's sin.
You expose
you
the
sin
so that light will shine.
You didn't expose it.
Lord Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
That's why he died. Yes, he died, and somehow he's the light, guys. He says to guide all of us, but you know, he went and got crucified and he died.
Before I bring the two sentences, can I please explain why in this context?
First, let's get the references so I understand, and then you explain it to me.
Here, I'll explain the whole context behind why ahad in that verse, because we're talking about قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَد right now.
Sir,
we're talking about قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَد.
So you are showing me word ahad is used
in this context.
In different contexts.
No, I'm talking about this context.
One of and one. So all I am asking is first let me read it and then I'll give you time to explain. Give me time, I'm not English speaker. If I am reading first time, I want to know what I'm reading.
Okay.
You got it.
So قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَد, okay. Can I please just say Allah, He is Allah. He is Allah, comma, the one and only. Okay, so let us analyze the sentence. هو الله أحد. Okay, so in this sentence, huwa is the subject.
So huwa? Where are you reading that from? Which scholar is telling you that? Or which
dictionary? Any Arabic expert can explain.
I went to Arabic experts. Arabic as Yasir Kadir and Norman Ali. And you discredit them already. So you don't tell me like whatever Arabic expert you go.
She told you explain Allah Ahad.
No, she wants another verse where Ahad is used as one of.
Isn't it?
She asked that question.
You made a claim that in the context it has been used differently. So I'm expecting you are going to provide me some evidence.
By the way, guys, Islam is the truth. So please convert. Trying to promote my entire ideology, you know. She's getting so angry. Look, oh no, I'm promoting Islam. Oh yeah. Oh. And some person here thinks she's an Arabic expert and she's from Turkey. She can't even speak Arabic. She doesn't understand Arabic as well.
Just a moment.
Go on.
Ibrahim?
Yep.
What's your name, sir?
Ahmed.
Ahmed. Can you tell Ahmed, tell you when I said I'm Arabic expert? Or when I said I'm...
You're trying to come and interpret. You're trying to interpret. You're trying to interpret the Quran.
Okay, I have a question.
You're trying to interpret the Quran.
I'll defend him. Can I defend him on this case?
You're trying to interpret the Quran.
Okay. What I interpreted, I brought you Islamic scholars. Give me your reference.
No. Because you denied the fact that you said you're Arabic expert. No, we're not good. We're going to stop on the facts. No.
You made a claim. We're going to respond to that claim.
You never said that you're Arabic experts. But you brought grammatical errors in the Quran.
Exactly.
Who can bring grammatical errors in the Quran?
Especially for a person that can't speak Arabic.
You claim to be an Arabic expert.
That's your interpretation and that's false claim. So now, give me, ahad has been used as one of and one.
Whose mic is this? Because I'm not trying to hold it. Because he's not speaking.
So Muslim is telling to other Muslims to don't waste your time. It's not worth enough. He was patient enough to
funny
give me the context.
Ahad in every context.
Is what?
Is used that's only the one. I'll take back my claim. Ahad has never been used to describe one of.
Okay, so you lied.
Huh?
No, he's
lied. No, I take back my claim.
So you lied.
I didn't lie.
So now, let's investigate the verses which Ahad is using your claims correct.
Okay.
Point out to me the verse Ahad has been used in which verses as one, only one.
Okay. So قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ.
After that, like you need to provide another verse beside that.
اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَّارُ. اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ
الْقَهَّارُ. Wait, I'm trying to search out.
Okay.
I don't know if I can find it.
Give me the reference.
For what?
It's not that book.
It's book text. You start reading breakfast time. By the evening, you finish it. It's not that big. It's really not that big. Don't give me a question. Give me the back up your claim.
Why do I need to follow what you said?
Because you just lied. Because you lied, we are gonna expose that lie.
Well, you lied. You said that in that context, Ahad means one of.
It is.
Who
according
you to
your scholar.
No.
All I did was, I am a messenger, don't hate me. I brought the message what your Muslim scholars are telling. Your Muslim scholars identifying Ahad as one of.
Okay.
It's not fine. They were pushing him around, sir.
I have a question.
Just ask my questions. Don't bring up new questions. Answer the questions. You need to back up. You need to back up. Ahad, it is worthy of discussion. I want to know Allah is what of what. I want to know. I showed you a dictionary. I already showed you a dictionary.
You didn't show a dictionary.
You read it. You read it, sir. I showed you the dictionary.
I showed you a dictionary.
Now, what is your reference?
Okay.
If we bring the Quran in English,
exactly.
And it's that.
We are not discussing. Okay. I want you to find the word Ahad is being used, and then show me as it is used as one and one of.
What is Allah saying?
I'll help you. Third Ahad is used in Surah 16, verse 76, as one of them.
Okay.
Open Surah 16, verse 76. 1676 as one of. Verse Ahad is used in Surah 15, verse 65 as one of. Verse Ahad is used in Surah 16, verse 58 as one of them. I'm telling you, sir, just check it out. Okay? Which one are you asking? So 1676 as one of them.
Okay.
Keep us going.
76.
أحدهما.
أحدهما. It's أحدهما. The word used is أحدهما.
أحدهما.
أحدهما is not used in قل هو الله أحد.
أحد أنا أحدهما.
وضرب الله مثلين. وضرب الله مثلا. وضرب الله مثلا رجلين. أحدهما. رجلين أحدهما. This is talking about man.
Mm-hmm.
Allah sets forth another parable of two men. Ahaduhuma is not used to describe Allah. It's used to describe two men.
I find it's very funny right now. And you should find it very funny now.
Let me speak.
I gave you five references where the word Ahad is used as one of.
You are failed to do that.
One of them.
There's a suffix.
Any of Ahaduhuma. One of them. So now. Don't do that again.
No, I'm telling you, be quiet.
Don't cry like that again. Okay. So,
okay.
Now,
according to the dictionary, according to the references,
Ahad is one of. Now, can you be kind enough and then tell us what is Allah one of what?
No problem. Let's read it in Arabic again. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا رَجُلَيْنِ أَحَدُهُمَا. This is not saying أحد. أحدهُمَا.
أحدهُمَا
is not the same thing.
It looks like you need of your mom.
Which was?
Surah 16, verse 76. She said,
"This gentleman needs of his mom with the actions he's just showing to people."
I want you to
tell me and be kind enough.
Yep.
What is Allah one of what?
Okay. First of all, I will read the translation because I don't think she can get it in her head that this is not talking about Allah. Allah sets forth. There's in brackets another parable of two men. One of them dumb, one of with no power of any sorts. So this is talking about one of them, which is talking about the man who has no power of any sorts. So this is not describing Allah. This is describing the man with no power of any sorts. A wearisome burden is he to his master, whichever way be directs to him. He brings no good. Is such a man equal with one who commands justice and is on the straight path?
Okay. Why are you trying to film it?
So I just disprove the claim that she said ahad means one of. Because here the word used is ahaduhuma. So there is a suffix, isn't it? Suffix huma. So there is a suffix huma which adds of them to ahad. So, can you bring, I have a question to
Hatun.
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 Can you bring another verse? Okay. Can you bring another verse where ahad means one of? Here we just disproved that ahaduhuma is not the same as ahad. Qul huwa Allah ahad. If one of them, if ahad was okay, okay, I'll speak. If ahaduhuma was used in Surah Al-Ikhlas, that means Allah would be one of them. But the surah says Qul huwa Allah ahad. I don't want to start going around in circles explaining the same point. I already disproved the claim that ahad means the one. Can you bring another verse where ahad is described as one of? We just disproved that verse. Okay, thank you.
So you made a claim. You made a claim, and your claim seemed to disagree with the scholars regarding ahad means ahad doesn't mean one of. I gave you Quranic verses where the word ahad used as one of.
It was not ahad.
It's ahaduhuma. It's ahaduhuma. I'm not cutting you because you're lying. You're lying. You're lying.
Why are you cutting me off?
Ahaduhuma. Look, look.
Why are you cutting me off?
I'm actually laughing to death.
Ahaduhuma. Why are you cutting me off?
Don't cut her off. Don't cut her off. Please speak.
Here's the bottom line. Hold Allah this. Is one of something.
Hold this.
Allah is one of something. Okay. In that one of something, all I am asking is Allah group of prostitute? Is Allah group of fruit? Is Allah group of rock? All that's all I am asking.
Okay.
What you hear is...
Can I please respond?
See?
Can I please
see?
Respond?
He doesn't even allow me to speak. I let him to do his research. He went to check Google. He discredited scholars. He discredited scholars. He discredited Allah's word. I can't do much about it. All I can say...
Stop making lies about...
See? Let me just summarize very basics. I am intentionally turning this camera around because this gentleman is causing
saying that ahad means one of
causing me stress. Therefore, I'm just turning the camera around.
Okay.
So let me give once again.
Another verse, can I please have another verse?
Let me give once again the problem of ahad, and then we finish from that.
Say that again.
One of something.
Say that again,
all
please.
All I am asking is Allah one of your options are here.
Okay.
If you are not happy with the options, pick another option. Your options are, is Allah a group of prostitutes? Is Allah group of fruit? Is Allah group of mountains? Is Allah group of rocks?
Okay, thank you. Can I please respond? If ahaduhuma was used after Allah, the verse would say Allah ahaduhuma.
Exactly.
But it never said that. It says darab Allahu mathalan rajulaini ahaduhuma.
So,
it's talking about rajulaini.
It's not saying Allah. And he's not even engaging the argument I put forward.
No, it's funny. It's funny.
He's not even engaging the argument I put forward.
No, I just disproved that. Even the camera showed.
If you tell ahad, and the word is not
ahad means one of, she said.
Is not using that. So, verse is being used as ahad. All I am asking, what is Allah part of?
Okay.
I think we come to the conclusion, Allah is simply, I'll go with, part of frogs.
Because
Allah is just a being. As a being, remember, Allah is what? Allah is not even who?
So, can you please,
therefore,
can you please,
let me,
okay,
let
can you
me make my
bring the
case.
Verse where it says the
my,
fruits?
My case.
The, can you please
I am very much aware. I am very much aware that Muslims are having problem with Allah. All I can say is, dear Muslims, turn to Lord Jesus Christ. We don't have any one of something.
For a God that died,
we don't have any,
a God that somehow died.
We don't have any confession about it. Lord Jesus Christ is identified as the King of Kings, Lord of Kings.
Allah.
Don't hang out with Ahad. Don't hang out with other junks. Hear that conversation. Bottom line is this.
Can I bring my conclusion after?
Today, Yasir Qadri can be identified as kafir. Norman Ali might be identified as kafir. And dictionaries might be wrong.
Okay.
But Allah doesn't use the word one in Surah 112 in Arabic. Allah uses the word which is identified as one of. So, don't play around those words. Whatever Allah is one of, Allah is not going to give you eternal life. Whatever Allah is one of, remember according to Islam, it is Muhammad gives you eternal life if you give him what is between your legs. All I can say is, run away from Islam, run away from Allah, turn to the Lord Jesus Christ, who loved you enough to give himself for you. Father loved humanity enough to give his one and only son, that one and only son gave his life for us. Turn to him in repentance, his arms are open, he wants you, he loves you, and he wants to share life with you.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulullah. We can conclude this debate by saying she lied about the Quran and she lied about the words of Allah. Ahad, we brought the definition of Ahad in that verse, which meant the one. She brought another verse where she said that Ahad means one of. But we concluded that the word was Ahaduhuma, which was one of. That means she lied about the Quran. She even brought another word to say that Ahad means one of, which was Ahaduhuma. Thank you. We can wrap up this video.
Nice one. Thank you, bro.